Hello, and welcome to today's video presentation on uninstalling Oracle KSplice online mode using Oracle Linux 8. This video shows how to remove the Oracle KSplice packages and unregister from the Unbreakable Linux network. So let's get started. Open a terminal for your system using Oracle KSplice. To remove the KSplice packages, type sudo space dnf space remove space ksplice space uptrack space dash y. Next, remove the ksplice-aware versions of glibc and the OpenSSL packages. To remove these packages, first unsubscribe this system from the ol8_x86_64_userspace_ksplice repository on ULN. In a browser, navigate to linux.oracle.com and log in if necessary. From the home page, click the Systems menu item in the upper left. This step redirects to the Home Systems page. Locate your system's name in the list under System Profiles. Click the system's name. This step redirects to the Systems Details page. On the Systems Details page under Subscribe Channels, click the Manage Subscriptions button on the right. From the Subscribe box under Subscriptions, Channels, double-click the KSplice Aware User Space Packages option to remove it to the available box. Click the Save Subscriptions button. Back in your system's terminal, we can now downgrade the glibc and OpenSSL packages. Type sudo space dnf space downgrade space glibc open curly bracket comma dash devel comma dash headers comma dash common close curly bracket space OpenSSL, open curly bracket, comma, dash, libs, close curly bracket. That completes the removal of the KSplice packages. Now unregister the system from ULN. Return to the browser, refresh the ULN page, and sign in again if necessary. Go to the home page. From the home page, click the Systems menu item in the upper left. This step redirects to the Home Systems page. Locate the system's name in the list under System Profiles. Click the system's name. This step redirects to the System Details page. Under the System's Details panel, click the Delete button on the right. In the confirmation window, click the OK button. That completes the removal of the system from ULN. Back in your system's terminal, we can verify the system's removal from ULN using DNF. Type sudo space dnf space repo list. This results in the message, there is an error communicating with ULN. ULN-based repositories will be disabled. rhn-plugin:// error communicating with server. The message was, : this system is not registered with this server. Lastly, remove any unnecessary packages and re-enable the Oracle Public Yum repositories. Remove the system's local ULN registration information. Type sudo space rm space /etc/sysconfig/rhn/systemid. Next, remove the ULN registration package by typing sudo space dnf space remove space rhn-setup. Re-enable the Oracle Public Yum repositories. Performing this step is made simpler because when registering with ULN, the registration process disabled the public repositories rather than removing them. Get a full list of your enabled and disabled repos by typing sudo space dnf space repo list space all. This list will help identify which repos to enable. Enable the first repo by typing sudo space dnf space config dash manager space dash dash set dash enabled space ol8_uekr6. Continue by typing sudo space dnf space config dash manager space dash dash set dash enabled space ol8_appstream. Then type sudo space dnf space config dash manager space dash dash set dash enabled space ol8_baseos_latest. Verifier repos are enabled by typing sudo space dnf space repo list. Afterward, type sudo space dnf space upgrade to bring your system up to date and apply the latest patches. With ksplice removed, remember the required reboot of the system after kernel updates, so the updates take effect. That completes the removal of Oracle ksplice and unregistering a system from ULN. Thank you for watching this video and enjoy exploring the benefits of Oracle ksplice. Additional information is available on ksplice and other Linux topics in the Oracle Linux 8 documentation or Oracle Linux Learning Library.